Hi, I'm Stephen. Welcome to Steety Films. It's currently 9:30 in the morning and I've just been to town and today could be open. Nice. Travis Strikes Again. Woohoo. Now, even though this is a bit of a conundrum because usually I buy most of my games in Smith's despite taking advantage of a £5 offer, but sadly though, it was not listed. Most of the digital and thing you can get in Smith's at the moment, then it is getting this physical, and because I think they're quite limited at the moment. Even though Funny Witch shown that Argos is selling this for like £30, which is not bad buy if you want a cheap physical release. And but sadly though, in regards to when I checked it this morning, literally this morning when I found out, oh, £30, I might get it. But sadly though, it's actually sold out, not only in my local stores, but also online as well. It's like, well, why would you sell this Argos? On release day is another thing, you can't buy it online, which is a bit disappointing. But either way though, I managed to get a copy in my local Game, because Game was actually selling it, even though it was £35 upwards. But I managed to get a copy because I didn't want to download like a 6GB kind of thing. You know, depends on how many megabytes it is installing it, but I think it could be 0 megabytes than it is, depends how much gigabytes or megabytes it is for the DLC, because this does have the season pass included. Anyway. But yeah, oh, I do remember though, when they were releasing the Nintendo Switch, before the Nintendo Switch, that Suda51 did statement, oh, we're going to bring a No More Heroes game coming to the Switch, and hope you like it, and it turns out to be this shenanigans in regards of, it's still part of the franchise from what I've heard, even though it's somewhat mixed opinions at the moment, but I still wanted to pick up a copy either way, since it came out today, and this month is all different topic. But yeah, I have played a bit of the No More Hero games, I should say, that is this developer in general, because the last game that I played from them is Let It Die, Let It Die. Anyway, but yeah, Let It Die. but yeah, that was exclusive on a different platform, and this is exclusive for the Nintendo Switch. Then it is some other games that were played, his games, on a different platform that's backwards compatible. Anyway, but I thought I'd get the game either way. So anyways, quick with jib jabber, let's open this. And I forgot to do the usual thing, but here's the front. I do like the front cover, I should say. And despite that, would be cool if that was an icon. That is, if it is an icon, I'll take a screenshot of it. But yeah, here is the side, and here is the back. Tells you more info about the game, and it does support the Pro Controller, etc. Anyway, sorry about that. I forgot to do my usual rating. Sorry. Well, I'm having the conundrum. I'm trying to pick up this game is another thing. Anyways, let's open her up and see what content we have inside. And basically, you just get this really nice artwork, which is really sweet, I should say. But yeah, you do get the code, and you basically just scratch it off of a coin, whatever. Hold on, let me just get this out. Yeah, so here is the code, what you can't see, of course. And it just tells you this and that in all different languages, because, you know, it's a European kind of thing. But yeah, that's the code anyway, so I'm going to scratch it off and redeem that. And here's the nice artwork you get. And here is the cartridge itself. But, well, I tried out this game, even though it's got mixed opinions at the moment, despite getting it digitally, it's all a different topic. But at least I get this with the season pass. It's a shame I didn't get £30 in Argos. Anyways, we'll leave it at that now. So that was my opening of Travis Strikes Again. Hope you really enjoyed this video. Anyways, I better go now. See you from Steety Films.